Hi everyone, I'm Cody at W3AMG with Bridgecom Systems. Today, we are going to be showing you how to use APRS on your Anytone. This is an awesome feature if you're out and about and you want your radio to transmit your location, both for fun and practical reasons. If you're in any kind of backcountry or emergency scenario, it's really great that your radio can actually be set up to automatically do this. That way, if you ever needed help, someone's gonna be able to track you down. The great thing is, if you ever wanna turn it off, it's super easy. Let's get into it. So go ahead, take your radio, plug that programming cable into your computer, and we'll plug that into the radio as well. Awesome. Go over here on your computer and click the COM port button right there. Make sure your radio is connected, which it is. Read from your radio. In this case, we've already done that, so we are in good shape. There's a few things we want to do first. First off, go up into Tool and then go to, Options right here. Once you're there, make sure all of these items I have here are checked. A lot of times it will come without these checked. You want to make sure your GPS, Bluetooth APRS, and analog APRS receive are all checked in this case. Don't know if the 500 hours record is on this radio, so we're not going to check that. Not going to be using that right now. Once we've done that, you want to also go to optional settings and just go to the GPS/ranging. Once you're there, this is how I have mine set up. Go ahead and set yours up as you wish, but I just have make sure GPS primarily is turned on and GPS positioning, just make sure that's turned on. You can also set your distance unit. If I want to change that to the inch system, I could, just like that. There we go. So we have it set up. Now go ahead and create yourself a new channel. We already have one set up here, so I'll walk you through how it works. If you want to just copy what I have for the most part, that's totally fine, but I will do my best to explain what the different things do. So we have the frequency. In the US, this is the standard APRS frequency, the 144.39. Go ahead and put that in there for your receive and transmit. And after that, we'll go ahead, select analog. Transmit doesn't really matter so much here. We can set that to turbo in case you ever wanted to manually transmit. Moving on, bandwidth, it's gonna be 25K. Busy lock, you can play around with that. That has some extra functionality. We're going to leave that off for here. And moving down, APRS report type, set that to analog. Then your APRS PTT mode, end of transmission, that's fine. Move on down, roaming, if you mess around with roaming, you can turn that on. In this case, we're leaving that off. Report frequency, we'll set that to 1. And we should be good to go here. Make sure on this side, you select the APRS receive, and then the analog APRS mute, unless you want to actually hear the APRS transmissions. Definitely check both of those options. After that, you are in good shape. Give it a name and click OK. Then go over to your zones. You can make a new zone for APRS or just put it in with one of your current zones. Just make sure that you add this channel we just created to a zone. After that, you should be good to go. So go ahead and click on the Write to Radio button. Click OK. And then just write the other data. After that, go ahead and click OK, and we should be able to unplug the radio at this point. Awesome, so it's booting back up. We can switch over to our new zone here. Now, we've set this one up to receive, so let's go ahead and set this radio up over here to be able to transmit. Awesome, so first up, I'm gonna plug in my programming cable here. We'll plug this into both the radio and the computer. This will be similar to the mobile, the plus version of it. If you're using an older radio without APRS receive, it might look a little bit different, but we're gonna focus on the newer ones here. Similar concept. So once we have that turned on, the radio turned on and connected, we can open up the CPS over here, go up to Tool, go to Options, and make sure all of these are checked here that we have, your GPS, Bluetooth, APRS, and analog APRS receive, make sure they're checked, and go to your optional settings, go to GPS and ranging, and make sure you have your GPS turned on, etc. Although that may not be necessary for receiving, it's a good idea to do it if you're messing around with APRS. Once we've done that, go to your APRS panel right down here. Click on that, and once you're there, you'll be greeted with a huge display of lots of information. This can be very confusing. So if you need help, the best way to learn this, at least for me, because I actually just learned all this, is just take a screenshot of this, or just pause the video here, and set up your radio just like this. That'll guarantee you get on the air and working, but I'm gonna dive into what some of the different things do. So we have the manual TX interval. This is how often it will let you manually transmit your APRS location if you want to limit that. In this case, I don't really care about that. I'm more interested in the automatic. So here's the automatic transmit interval. So we can set this. I have it real short at 30 seconds. So every 30 seconds, my radio is actually going to transmit the APRS location based on my GPS. Now, if we wanted to increase that, let's say to 360 seconds, we can make that take longer. That's gonna obviously use less battery power, and just the radio is not gonna have to be tied up transmitting as often that way. So go ahead and set that for whatever you like. For the test, we're gonna keep it short. Support for roaming, if you plan on using roaming, just go ahead and turn that on. There's some other options. Now, if for some reason you were in an area where you could not get a GPS lock, or for some reason you don't want to use your GPS location, you can actually turn on fixed location beacon. This is cool. I don't really use it much, but it is useful. You can turn that on and send out your location without having a GPS signal. Just go ahead and turn that on and it will send out the coordinates that you enter in here down below and as your location. So technically, even if you're in an emergency and didn't have GPS coverage, if you know where you are, you can send out that beacon. Going down, the APRS tone, go ahead and turn that off unless you want to hear it. It's pretty annoying, so I would recommend turning that off. The to call, this is what we recommend setting it to. Just, it should come set this way. You can play around, learn more about what that's all about. Then your SSID, the to call SSID, just make sure it's set to something. We'll provide you with some information on what all these different SSIDs actually mean. Then your call sign, obviously that's your just amateur radio call sign. Your SSID, we'll have a list down below you can take a look at. This gets updated periodically, but currently, if I was in a mobile operation, I'm gonna choose -9. That's what I have set here. We're setting this up as if we were going to be driving around in our car. Then below this, this is the actual symbol that's going to show up on the map. So if you look at APRS.fi, which is a really cool website, you can actually see all the APRS information going on. If we were to look there, this is what we will show up as. Again, we'll have some information down below, but you can actually get a diagram that will show you all the different symbols, and then based on what you choose, we can pick what symbol we want to be. So if I wanted to be the car, just a small car, I can go ahead and choose the forward slash, and then this little icon here, this right arrow. There we go. And then down below that, destination path, where this is DigiPeter path, there's a few options there. In this case, I'm using wide 2-2. Depending on your location, DigiPeter setup, etc., you may want to change this. Just find out whatever information is for your area. After that, then enter your sending text. This is the text you're actually sending along with the transmission. It's gonna send your call sign, stuff like that. So if you needed help, this would be where you put help. Now, you would probably also may wanna indicate help with your icon if you have the opportunity to do that. If not, definitely the message is your best place to put that. But if you just wanna send out a different kind of message too, you can put that here. Moving on, the transmit delay. Here's some just recommended numbers. Just set that at 600. Leave your subtone off. We can turn that off there. Your DCS, you can do D, just 000. Pre-wave time, 600. Transmit power, most likely turbo, depending on what your application is. And you should pretty much be set there. Those are some baselines to work with. You can tweak these depending on your location and what you want to do with it. But this is what we recommend. Now, for the actual frequency, your transmission frequency, in the US, that's going to be 144.39. Just keep that in mind. So what I've done here is just set all of my analog transmissions to 144.39. Just go ahead and change them over to that if you're in the US. If you're in a different location, just go ahead and use whatever your standard is. After that, you are pretty much set in this menu. Do keep in mind, over here on the right-hand side, position does need to be checked. In fact, if you want to, you could just check all of these to guarantee success, but if you leave position unchecked, you will have some trouble. So again, you also want the transmit to be wide. Make sure that's set to wide down here and click OK. And at this point, what we can do is go ahead and make sure our radio is still connected, which it is. write that to our radio, just like that. And that's going to write to the radio. And at this point, our radio is actually going to transmit APRS. So this one's set up to receive, and this one's going to transmit now that we just set it up. Now, if you want to verify that your radio is actually switched on to transmit APRS, you can just go to menu and go to APRS, select that, go to upload type. In this case, see, we were actually switched off. So make sure you just set that to A, go ahead and select that, and now we are gonna be in good shape. Our radio is now set up to transmit APRS. So we're gonna give it a minute here. Looks like we do not have a GPS lock. So until we get a GPS lock, this is not going to transmit. In the studio, that can be tough. So we may have to take this outside and show you how it works. Alrighty, so here we are outside the building. Both of my GPS signals have locked on now. So let's wait for a transmission. This radio is the one we set up to receive. So if we give it a second here, this should transmit its APRS location, and hopefully we can pick it up over here. Go, it's sending data. There we go. How cool is that? It worked. So we just received an APRS signal. You see it says car, and that shows us what type of vehicle we're using. Now, after you have your APRS all set up, if you set up your receiver transmit, what you may want to do is actually monitor yourself or what other people are doing on the APRS network. So if your area has a local digipeater, you'll actually be able to see local activity. So let me show you how. Go to a web browser and go to aprs.fi. Once you're there, you'll be able to select your location. We'll wait for it to pull up here. You can select your location. In this case, we have the Kansas City area, and see all of the activity in that area. You can do all sorts of cool things, filter by time, by location, and see your local activity.